Oh, we had a mini F. Let's see if we're still up. Okay, let's see if. Okay, we're good. We're back. We're back. That was sad. I hate when the freaking internet drops. Like, I pay so much fucking money to get that good shit. It's okay though. Maybe it's 'cause, like, I know someone just came home for lunch, so maybe someone is fucking up my upload speed. I mean, I pay for the internet bill, so. Because even though I'm not working, because I saved enough money to last me a while. Like, I have enough saved for maybe 6 more months now. But, like, I help pay my share of rent. And then, internet. I can't pay the utilities anymore because I loan my dad a lot of money. He wanted to get a car. So, I used to pay like the utilities, like trash, electricity, but I told him, I was like, you know, I gave you that $4,000, like, I'll pay me back at some point. So I was like, I cannot pay utilities until I get that $4,000 back. And he's like, okay, valid. So. Yeah, this hand shape is whack, dude. Maybe I just need to practice hands more. Honestly, this left hand, the shape is to me a lot more realistic than the right hand. I think because a lot more of the fingers are defined, not as hidden. Also, because like you're seeing the pads of the fingers, like you're not seeing the actual nail bed. Because So I typically will draw like front facing ones. Yeah, that shape is definitely interesting. Because it makes sense for like the open end to be facing us, because like the wrist is facing us, but this one the wrist is facing backwards. So then, like reality, the gap would be facing away. So even though it looks better to have like an open gap on the right hand, it's not realistic because you have to think about like placement, where that form would be. Because like this one, the wrist would go back this way, like it's not facing us. Find that a little bit more. There's so many different waves in this reference. It almost looks like Medusa's hair. So many explicit like curls and coils. I need to just get better at drawing curls, so. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think I have all the bass lines done. I think, depending whether or not I want to use color today, because I really like the look of doing like line work and then just doing the hair in like a bright color. I think that might be a look for this one. We'll see, we'll see. I think I'll just go in with my darkest black for now and debate in my head if I want to do color. I think for this one, I'll go with explicit black and then maybe use color later. Ooh, one stroke, look at that. That's perfect. This is not as good, but still, it's a really nice stroke. Definitely a lot more of a cartoony look to this one. For this one, I could have gone with using just fine liners. It would be in a bit more detail. I think I'll leave these outlines there and then go in with color. And by color, I just mean like flat color fill, maybe some blending with tone bows. Because I know for me, I really like flat colors, flat fills, mainly because like it still is a bit abstract. I think it'll be a look if I just fill in like the bottom line of the eyebrow, maybe. It kind of be like how people fill in brow line. I mean, I don't know anything, like anything about makeup. I've never ever done or worn makeup. It's probably a sensory thing. I have a lot of sensory issues now that I think about it. Like, the only time I ever worn, like, face paint or makeup was in kindergarten. We had, like, a play where we were circus, so I was a clown, and I wanted to be a seal, because the teacher was like, hey, everyone gets to choose two things, and I didn't realize that it was in order of priority or preference, so I said clown and seal, when I actually wanted to be a fucking seal. So I got to be a clown, because like no one else wanted to be a fucking clown, right? So of course Megan got it, and it sucked because I had to wear the makeup for like an hour before we had to go to the school, and then the play was like an hour, and it was horrible. Like, I don't even like getting water on my face. Like, if I have the option, I'll go with taking a bath over a shower. I think for this, I just want to put very thin, large eyelashes, because this one is going to be like fully stylized. The proportions are already kind of whack in this one, so might as well dive into that fully.
Makes your head spin pretty
It's almost like this eye needs to be darker. Like the lid needs to be hooded more. Because this one is a lot darker when compared to this one. Also, because like I made this eye shape a lot larger. Like the gaps right here are a lot bigger than this one. Darken the lid a little bit more. I think I can make this one a little bit more hooded. Because this right eye curves downward, and this one curves a lot, a bit more upward. It's almost like she has two different shaped eyes. I'm just thickening these bottom lashes a bit more to darken the eyes a little bit. Because I want the eyes to be the darkest element in this piece. Maybe it'd be a look if you made the bottom lashes fuller. The top ones. I always found like really big eyelashes like creepy. Because it's almost drawing too much attention to your eyes. So I know I prefer when people wear like light makeup. As I said earlier, like I don't wear makeup myself. So, I know people are always like, oh, you look so better with a bare face, but like, I legit believe that. Like, sometimes makeup is too much. I mean, y'all can do whatever you want. I've also been practicing caricature on the side. I think it'd be fun to do live caricatures. Like with an actual easel and stuff. So I always like those booths at like fairs and stuff. I've never gotten one done, but I'd always ask if I can like just watch and work for a bit. Because with caricature you gotta work fast, right? Because you usually have a line, two or three clients. And just be able to render that quickly. A lot of them is just simple strokes and learning how to manipulate your brush to make those strokes. I'm still holding on to you. All the days we're colored blue. And people think caricatures are just exaggerations, but there's so much more to it than that. Like my aunt, she has this caricature she got at Disney, like 30 years ago, and she got a full color one. It's like with color pencils and stuff, and it's so nice. And to me, something like that is a lot more memorable than getting a photo, because there's a lot more craftsmanship to it. Didn't this song like literally just play? I feel like it did. Yeah, it's just a different version on it. Don't like that. Making the weirdly proportioned hands. I think the best part about inking is deciding where to add weight. Adding some details to the eyes now. Adding some lines to make it a bit more cartoony. Very subtle, but it'll make it darker. See how here the lines are slightly thinner, and then here where the weight with the shadows typically would be, bottom lines are thicker. I was gonna say, I wish my ink jar was clear. Then I was like, no way that'd work, because the ink is dark enough to where like it would stain the jar anyway, so big brain. Wherever you go. But I think for this one, I want to make the plumes slightly thicker. That way, when I do color in, the areas for coloring will be bigger. Too much ink. This one literally just played. Maybe I can change the filter to now there's no, because like they have like the original song and then the strip version or like acoustic version, and it's like I don't like that. Changing the genre. When you first told me your name, I didn't hear a word you said. Bet it was written all over my face. Should have known it was you I would love until the end. When you made it down the aisle, every moment stole my breath. Bet you could see it in my smile. Should have known it was you I would love. Till the end, I don't know where this road leads. All I know is I wanna go with you in a life where there's no sure things. I am sure I wanna live it with you. If you look into my eyes, when our time down here is spent, it's in every single line. Hope you know it was you that I loved until the end. Ooh, too much ink, too much ink. Well, I've been pacing up and down your drive, trying to get the
tell by the way you were looking at me, I was found. For you counted down, you watched my every move. Like a blind man finally seeing something, I've been finding every road has led to you.
Love how I said I want to keep the hair strands larger. They're all so small. I mean, it makes sense because it's near the top of the head. It's not as much definition on the top, so kind of valid. I think I just need to be less critical of myself. Because, like, I'm trying to be... It's important to be critical, because critical, like, a critique is something positive along with a negative. People think just negative input is criticism, but it's not. Because with critiques, you want to build up. Like, improve. Like, you can't just shit on someone and expect them to get better. That's why, like, if I ever see someone's work and I, like, comment on it or something, I will say something specific that I like about it. Like, oh, your line work is really nice, or the form is great. Because I think just a vague comment where it's like, oh, nice work, it's like that what makes it nice, you know? I feel like I should add one of my line over here to find the shape a little bit better. I'm honestly really enjoying streaming the gaming stuff. The only issue I see happening is it getting stale. Like, especially the stupid Mario Kart concept, like, it's gonna take me a long ass time to beat it. I mean, it's fine, because, like, it's a pretty, like, engaging game just in general. Like, what I'm worried about is, like, what am I going to do next? Because I don't want to, like, bounce between games. Because I think it'd be better if I did one game at a time. And that's just also how I play games in, like, my free time, too. Like, I usually have to beat it first before I start another one. That's a cool strand. A lot of weight and... I like how curly these strands are. And all this time I thought I knew. Because honestly, it's really discouraging to like see people like show up and then leave. Which I get it, that's what I do when I watch like smaller streamers. Like, I will say like, oh, I'm really quiet. And then, like, I like really engaging content, like people who are talking all the time, but it's like, that's not what I do. But then there's some people who like more chill stuff. Just like, I just can't get complacent. It's also funny because, like, my parents are really into, like, gardening and landscaping. So they'll watch, like, family vlog channels, and all they do is garden. And it's the funniest thing. Like, that's all they watch on YouTube. Because, like, sometimes, because, like, we have a TV in the living room, and my YouTube account is on there. And sometimes they'll accidentally click on mine, so they'll watch on my account. And then when I get on like my phone, like all my recommended is farming shit. I'm like, ah, oh, no. It's funny because my mom was like, we can do that too. I'm like, yeah. I was like, you realize you can't be mean on camera, right? Area looks really weird. It looks too cluttered almost. Yeah, this part is really dark. You can see how that is like the darkest value. Because those lines are really close. Maybe I can try getting this line a bit. That way it doesn't blend in too much with the hairlines. Add a bit more weight to them. Yeah, that balances out a little bit more. Okay, time for the other side. Like in the ref, this finger is tucked under. But I kind of like how it looks better sticking out the front, that we can tell it's a hand. But since that one's still covered, it's a lot harder to identify. This finger is very long though. Nah, I could just see its style. It's honestly not feeling this drawing when I started, but it's coming along a lot better now. It's getting ready to just end stream, be like, nah, now we good. Pulled through. I'm gonna add a bit more weight to the bottom of this one, similar to the wrist here. That way it doesn't mesh too much with the hair.